It will surely take a few days for all of us to get over from pictures showing people falling from aircrafts. Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Knowing More. If you are new here, do subscribe as I'm sure that you would love my content. Today's video is on Taliban, whether it is the new one or the same old Taliban. To understand Taliban 2021, we need to know the Taliban 1996. That is the old Taliban. Why is it called Taliban 1996? Because it is in this year that they came to power in Afghanistan. They ruled Afghanistan till 2001 until America and its allies deceived them for helping Osama bin Laden. The birth and rise of Taliban can be understood by this timeline. The year 1979. To understand the roots of Taliban, we need to go back to the year 1979. This was the year when Soviet Union occupied Afghanistan. When the Soviet Union intervened and occupied Afghanistan, Islamic Mujahideen fighters engaged in war with them. Here the seeds of Taliban were sown, as nearly all of Taliban's original leadership previously fought in the Soviet-Afghan war for different factions of the Mujahideen. The fight against Russian forces continued till 1992. The year 1992. In April 1992, after the fall of the Soviet-backed regime of Mohammad Najibullah, many Afghan political parties agreed on a peace and power-sharing agreement called the Peshawar Accord. The Peshawar Accord was signed, which created the Islamic State of Afghanistan and appointed an interim government for a transitional period. The state was paralyzed from the start due to the rival groups contending for total power over Kabul and Afghanistan. The conflict between these militias escalated into a civil war. The year 1994. The Taliban first emerged on the scene in 1994. Mullah Mohammad Amar, in September 1994, in his hometown of Kandahar, with 50 students, founded this group. The Taliban are a movement of religious students from the Pashtun areas of eastern and southern Afghanistan who were educated in traditional Islamic schools in Pakistan. The Taliban announced that they would liberate Afghanistan from its present corrupt leadership of warlords and establish a pure Islamic society. The year 1996. It took them just 2 years to take control of Afghanistan. Taliban entered Kabul on 27 September 1996 and established the Islamic Emirate of Afghanistan. Moving on, let's understand, why is the world, and specifically, why are people of Afghanistan so scared of Taliban? Well, the answer to this question lies in understanding what they did during their rule between 1996 and 2001. Among the countless atrocities that Taliban did against the Afghani people, I would like to highlight a few of them. The first one being the massacre campaigns. According to a 55-page report by the United Nations, the Taliban, while trying to consolidate control over northern and western Afghanistan, committed systematic massacres against civilians. UN officials stated that there had been 15 massacres between 1996 and 2001. They also said that these have been highly systematic and they all have led back to the Taliban Ministry of Defense or to Mullah Omar himself. The second one being human trafficking. Several Taliban commanders ran a network of human trafficking, abducting ethnic minority women and selling them into sex slavery in Afghanistan and Pakistan. Time magazine writes, "The Taliban often argued that the restrictions they placed on women were actually a way of revering and protecting the opposite sex. The behavior of the Taliban during the 6 years they expanded their rule in Afghanistan made a mockery of that claim." Perhaps the most brutal atrocity committed by the Taliban was the oppression of women. Brutal repression of women was widespread under the Taliban and faced significant international condemnation. Abuses were countless and were violently enforced by the religious police. The Taliban issued edicts forbidding women from being educated, forcing girls to leave schools and colleges. Women leaving their houses are required to be accompanied by a male relative and were obligated to wear the burqa. Those accused of disobeying were publicly beaten and even executed. Number 4. Violence against civilians. According to United Nations, the Taliban and its allies were responsible for 76% of civilian casualties in Afghanistan in 2009, 75% in 2010, and 80% in 2011. Number 5. Discrimination against Hindus and Sikhs. Hindus and Sikhs have lived in Afghanistan since historic times and were a prominent minority in Afghanistan. After the Afghan Civil War, they started to migrate to India and other nations. After the occupation of Taliban regime in Afghanistan, they imposed a strict Sharia law, and thereafter discrimination against them started, and the population of Hindus and Sikhs fell at a very fast rate. Number 6. Violence against aid workers and Christians. Taliban between 2008 and 2012 several times claimed to have assassinated Western and Afghani medical or aid workers in Afghanistan, either for fear of vaccination of children against polio, or for suspicion that the medical workers were in truth spies, or for suspecting them to be propagating Christianity. Number 7. Restricting modern education. Before the Taliban came to power, education was highly regarded in Afghanistan, and Kabul University attracted students from across Asia and the Middle East. However, the Taliban imposed restrictions on modern education, banned female education, and encouraged only Islamic religious schools and the teaching of Quran. Around half of the schools in Afghanistan were destroyed. The Taliban have carried out brutal attacks on teachers and students and issued threats to parents and teachers. As per the 1998 UNICEF report, 9 out of 10 girls and 2 out of 3 boys did not enroll in schools. By 2000, fewer than 4-5% of Afghan children were being educated at the primary level, and even fewer at higher secondary and university levels. Number 8. Cultural genocide. The Taliban have inflicted cultural genocide on the Afghan people by destroying their historical and cultural texts, artifacts, and sculptures. In 1992, it attacked and looted the National Museum of Afghanistan, resulting in the loss of 70% of the 1 lakh artifacts of Afghan culture and history. On 11th August 1998, it destroyed the Puli Kumri Public Library. The library contained over 55,000 books and old manuscripts and was considered by the Afghans as one of the most valuable and beautiful collections of their nation and their culture. Who can forget what Taliban did in March 2001? On 2nd March 2001, the Buddhas of Bamiyan were destroyed with dynamite on orders from its leader, Mullah Omar. Number 9. Ban on entertainment and recreational activities. During the Taliban rule of 1996-2001, they banned many recreational activities and games, such as football, kite playing and chess. General entertainment such as television, cinema, music and satellite dishes were also banned. It has been reported that when children were caught kiting, a highly popular activity among Afghan children, they were beaten. Well, all this is surely very heartbreaking to hear. Now, is it the new Taliban or the old one? Feared for its brutal and oppressive reign 2 decades ago, the group has tried to present a more moderate image since it took effective control of Afghanistan this week. It has, for instance, claimed women will have all rights, including to education and work, and that the media will be independent and free. It has also insisted that no threat will be posed to any country. To understand whether Taliban have changed, we should look into the news reports trickling out of Afghanistan after Taliban took power. The first 8 to 9 days do not show any change in Taliban, as the moderate stance which they are talking about is not being enforced on the street level. The moderate stance which their spokesperson was talking was for the international community so that the country does not attract harsh sanctions. The Afghani people, especially their women, their minority community, people who supported the government or the NATO forces, are really going to have a very harrowing time of their life. We can only hope that the international community wakes up and stands for the rights of the Afghani people. Friends, I know some of you might be thinking it's Afghanistan's internal problem or it's US and its allies' problem. Well, even if we keep the human angle aside, I would like to draw your attention on 2 points. The first point is 9/11 attacks. The foremost reason for 9/11 attacks was the unconditional support of Taliban to Al-Qaeda. One thing we can surely understand, that Taliban is not afraid. If it could do that to America, it can do it to any nation of the world. The second one is the ideology of Taliban. They are an insurgent group with very less belief in ethics and morals. Every country in the world has a group of unhappy people, and Taliban could support them to destabilize any country in the world. Well, friends, Taliban's rule is bad not just for the Afghani people but for the world as a whole, as the Afghani soil could be used to unsettle any country. We hope that the world does not wake up to another 9/11, as I feel that all the power games played by the political heads of nations results in sufferings for the common man in any country of the world. Hope you loved my content. If you did, please like, share and subscribe. Also, do not forget to leave your valuable comments below.